Good morning, everybody. I welcome you all back for the part two of ecosystem. Yesterday we did the webinar because we are celebrating the International Day of Biological Diversity on May 22. For that, I have planned three functions, competitions, poster and dry arrangement flower, which you did. I thank you all for maximum participation, and the results are soon ready to be displayed. And the third competition is PowerPoint presentation, which the MSA2 did yesterday in webinar. The details of webinar are already posted and the recording will be soon shared with you people, and I hope you all will see the recording and see how and what to do for the next year, because you people are coming next year for these webinars. But in coming days we are coming with the webinars of declamation contest, because you have already written the essay writing competition. So those who have yet not submitted their 1 mark of celebration posters, slogans and essay. So I will shortlist them for the declamation contest. So again, thank you all for your cooperation. Yesterday's excellent function, commanded by our chief guest, Professor Pramila Pathak, Botany Department, Punjab University, and our worthy principal, Professor Anita Kosha. And besides that, I again remind you to please submit these soon, so we will go ahead with the declamation contest, which occurs in three categories. I already sent you the messages for that, right? So stay indoors, stay safe. I'll be right back for part two of ecosystem. Stay on. Good morning, everybody. I welcome you all back for the part two of ecosystem. I just want to revise you first what we did day before yesterday. What is ecosystem and the structure of ecosystem? This is structure of ecosystem in which the sun rays, that is solar energy, is converted to the chemical energy by producers. And these producers, they are in turn eaten by the consumers. And both when dead, the death and decay, they are converted into nutrients by means of a decomposers, right? And these nutrients, by biogeochemical cycling, they move into the atmosphere and soil. So another thing we did is the trophic levels. As the sun rays comes, they are first converted solar energy to chemical energy by producers, which are in trophic level T1. And these producers are eaten by the herbivores, which are called primary consumers, which is T2. And herbivores are eaten by the secondary consumers or primary carnivore, T3. And then subsequently by secondary carnivore, T4, and top carnivore, T5. And they all are eaten by the decomposers, right? So this up to T1. Till T5, we have the grassland food chain, and from this T5 to T6, we have the detritus food chain, right? So yesterday, then other thing we did is the abiotic components, biotic components. Biotic components, it is of producers, consumers and decomposers, also called micro consumers. And abiotic components, they are help in the nutrients, which help in the cycling of matter, and biogeochemicals we did in the coming days. And today we are doing, that is second part of that biotic component, flow of energy, that comes under food chain and food web. So food chain and food web will do today, right? So now I will start today's topic, that is food chain. Food chain, the transfer of food energy from producers through a series of organisms, that is herbivores to carnivores to decomposers, with repeated eating and being eaten. These lines are very important, with repeated eating and being eaten. If you want to write Just concise, repeated eating and being eaten is called food chain. So this is the process chain where the producers, they are eaten by the herbivores and then to the primary carnivore, secondary and top, and ultimately to the decomposers. So the green plants which occupy the first trophic level are called producers. When herbivore, which are also called primary consumer, which occupy second trophic level, they feed on the plants. So the food energy is transferred, right? So next, from the autotroph to the primary consumers, herbivores are in turn eaten by the carnivores, which constitute the third trophic level. And these are in turn eaten by the secondary and top, which constitute the fourth and fifth. The carnivore belonging to the trophic levels T3 and T4 are called predators. So now this question will come, which trophic level carnivores are called predators, right? So now we are coming to the saprophytic fungi. Bacteria and detritivorous animals like protozoa, nematodes, snails constitute the last trophic level and obtain energy from all the trophic levels by the process of decomposition from T1 to T5, which represent the grazing food chain, which I already told, and T6 represent the detritus food chain. So from T1 to T5, it is the grazing food chain, and this T6 is the detritus food chain. So in nature, there are two types of food chains, grazing food chain and detritus food chain. First, we are doing the grazing food chain. This food chain predominantly consists of photosynthetic plants who trap sun radiated energy through process of photosynthesis. The producers, that is grass plants, are eaten by herbivores. Herbivores are grasshopper, goat, deer, horse, elephant, cow. And the process of eating and re-eating take place and energy flow in the food chain. That is, autotrophs, they are eaten by the herbivores, then primary carnivore, then secondary carnivore. And this type of food chain is directly dependent on the sun, because the energy is coming from the sun, right? So it is directly dependent on the sun. Most of the ecosystem in nature follow this type of food chain, that is grass, cattle, man. Grass, rabbit, fox, wolf, tiger, the second food chain. Then vegetation, insect, frog, snake, peacock. Then phytoplanktons, zooplanktons, this is in pond, crustaceans, small fish, large fish and sharks. And last, algae, herbivorous fish, small carnivorous fish and large carnivorous fish. These are the food chains which are occurring in the nature. But I already told you yesterday, in nature there is no food chain like thing. It is the food web, right? So now we are coming to the next part. Very important. Without that, I will not imagine even competition exams or papers without detritus food chain. So if you have come with the food chain, so you are not supposed to give grazing food chain, you have to give detritus food chain also. But it come in paper by name, detritus food chain. In BSc 3, if you take the 10-year exams, last exam, 8 times it came. This type of food chains, they goes from the dead organic matter into the microorganisms and then to detritivores and decomposers. Such ecosystem are less dependent on direct solar energy. This question will come. So which is not dependent on solar energy, that chain is called detritus food chain, and this is belongs to trophic level T6 decomposers. So these depend on the organic matter produced in another system. A good example of detritus food chain is based on leaves of red mangrove Rhizophora mangle, described by Herald in 1969. And this is the best example, that is the leaves of red mangrove and Odom in 1970. The leaves of red mangrove, that is Rhizophora mangle, they fall into warm shallow water. Only 5% of leaf material was removed by the grazing insect before leaf fall. So before leaf fall in Rhizophora mangliae, the leaves are 5% grazed, so 95% its decomposition occurs in the water. The fallen leaf fragments first acted upon by the saprotrophs as bacteria, fungi, and colonized by the benthic and phytoplankton algae. These colonized fragments are eaten and re-eaten by a group of animals, and these animals include crabs, copepods, insect larvae, grass shrimps, mycete, nematodes, amphipods, bivalve mollusk. These all animals are called detritus consumers. These animals are in turn eaten by the small carnivores, that is minnows and small game fish, which are re-eaten by the large carnivores, that is game fish and fish eating birds, and these are called chop carnivores. So this is very important. I already told you detritus food chain. So I start here. You will see it is the leaves of the red mangrove, that is Rhizophora mangliae, and when it falls, it is first grazed up to 5%, and that is 95% it falls on the shallow water. They are first acted upon by the fungi, bacteria and protozoan, and subsequently they are colonized by the phytoplankton and benthic algae. Now they are eaten and re-eaten by the detritus consumers. You can go first make this one. That is grass shrimp, then herpetocoid copepod, then crabs, then bivalve mollusks. If the outer circle is formed, then we come to the inner one. Then inner, we have the nematode, and opposite is insect larvae. And to below, there are sheep head minnows, and this insect larvae moves to the up, and this up we have the amphipod. And these are called detritus consumers. And these detritus consumers, they are eaten by the small carnivores, that is minnows or small game fish, and then ultimately, subsequently, by the large top carnivores, game fish and fish eating birds. Whereas in some books, it is written directly in linear form, like this. That is wrong. If you have come with the detritus food chain, you have to give this one. Right? Now we are coming to the next part, that is the food web. So as I already told you, there is nothing in nature, there is no food chains can exist. Many food chains exist in ecosystem, but in nature, linear and independent food chains are rare. It's nearly not possible. And these food chains, they are interconnected with each other, forming sort of interlocking pattern, and these are called food web. In other words, complex interrelated food chains make up a food web. So in grassland food web, there are five food chains which are interlinked in the scheme. See, in grassland we have this one, grass, grasshopper, hawk, grass, grasshopper, lizard and hawk, grass, rabbit and hawk, and then we have the grass, mouse and hawk, and last fifth chain is grass, mouse, snake and hawk. But this does not exist in nature like this linear form, but they exist like this. This is grass is the producer, it is taken by the grasshopper. Grasshopper are taken directly by the hawk, or grasshopper they taken by the lizard and then by the hawk. So the top carnivores are the hawk. Grass eaten by the rabbit and rabbit by the hawk directly. Grass eaten by the mouse, mouse by the hawk directly, or mouse by the snake and snake by the hawk. This is how the food chains, they are present, which are called food web in grassland system, right? So food web basically is responsible to maintaining the stability of the ecosystem, that is decrease in the mouse population. See, if decrease in the mouse population, and what will happen? The rabbit population is increased, right? So decrease in the mouse population would naturally increase on other herbivore population like rabbit, and results in increase of consumer that feed in. It results in the feed in snake. If grasshopper will increase, then what will increase? Lizard and hawk. So lizards will first increase, then hawk ultimately. So it will increase of consumer that feed on the herbivore whose population increases and results in the balanced ecosystem. So food web is results in the stabled and balanced ecosystem, and which is essential for the survival of all living organisms in land and pond. Figure 4, which we did with explanation, right? 3. So crux abstract is the food web maintains the stability. So depending upon the interrelation, there are different types of links. This is very important. The question will come. First is LOTA link, a direct minded unbranching link in the food web between prey species and predator. I already told you that predators are basically the question will come that in which trophic level the predators are formed. It is T3 and T4 are called predators. So it is an unbranching link, LOTA link, right? And you must have seen LOTA in our houses. It is not branched. Then we have the lambda link. So lambda is a branched, dichotomous branch in food web involving one predator feeding on two species. And gamma link is the reverse. It is a dichotomous branch but had two predators feeding on a prey species. It is different. Here two species, here one predator, here two predator and one. So lambda and gamma. So in this way, food web helps in maintaining equilibrium and stability in an ecosystem. A balanced ecosystem is very essential for the survival of all living organisms. This maintains homeostasis in ecosystem, which we did yesterday. When all the components are balanced, it is called homeostasis. If one of the component is not balanced or it results in unbalanced form, it is called eco-catastrophic. So, or catastrophic, we did yesterday. So, now I am coming to the ecosystem. Ecosystem, what we did, biotic components we did, abiotic we did, producers, carnivores, consumers we did. And now today we did is the flow of energy, food chain, food web. And tomorrow I will doing the cycling of matter, that is biogeochemical cycling, very important topic. And then we can move to the other parts, that is ecological pyramids and particularly this flow of energy, the energy flow in ecosystem. There are three topics which are left. But tomorrow I am doing the biogeochemical cycle, a very important topic. And I already explained that the types of ecosystem are natural and artificial. Natural is the artificial is man-made and natural is the natural one, right, of terrestrial and aquatic, right? So in aquatic we have basically one the questions comes is the fresh water, that is lotic, that is spring, river and stream, and lentic is the lake, swamps and ponds. So this I finishes what we did yesterday, that is structure of ecosystem. Then I just move on to the trophic levels, and from trophic levels as I already told you, T1 to T5 is the grassland food chain and T6 is the decomposers, and these basically T3 and T4. See, T3 and T4 are the predators, right? And then I move to the process of food web, and in food web I told you this there is no food chain like thing in the nature there, but they are interlinked, and this is called food web, and these food webs will help in maintaining equilibrium and stability in the ecosystem. And this food webs have links, which is unbranched is called LOTA link, and which are branched, which are called lambda and gamma. But if one predator and two species, lambda, if reverse, that is two predator and one species, it is called gamma. So then I already said that if food chain question will come, then you have to give the two food chain, grassland and detritus. In detritus, it is basically studied by Herald 1969 and Odom in 1970 in the Rhizophora mangala, that is the red mangrove. And these red mangrove, when the leaves fall, the 5% they are earlier grazed, and as it falls, it is acted upon the fungi, bacteria and protozoan, and ultimately they are colonized by the phytoplankton and benthic algae. And then they are subsequently eaten by the detritus consumers like grass shrimp, herpecticoid copepod, crabs, bivalve mollusk, then nematode, sheephead minnow, insect larva, and amphipod. And these detritus consumers, they are eaten by the small carnivores, minnows, and small game fish. And they are eaten by the large or top carnivores, that is game fish and fish eating birds. And this is very important, I already told you. So please revise these, and these are very important. And because I already told you, so this basic detritus food chain is very, very important. So anyhow, then stay indoors and stay safe. I'll be right back tomorrow. Take care. Bye-bye.